When I started my life in science, chemotherapy and radiation therapy were really the only armament for cancer medicine. My name is Lisa Cousins, and I am very proudly the AACR president this year. We have now a revolution in immune therapies. And when you put that together with the combination of targeted therapies, chemo and radiation therapy, we now have patients that would have died within 2 years of a diagnosis, living 15, 20, 25, 30 years, essentially cured of their malignancies. The remarkable advances that we've seen in cancer medicine, bringing together molecularly targeted agents with a diversity of immune modulating agents. The remarkable thing about all of those new approaches for cancer medicine is that they stem from fundamental discoveries in basic science. The molecular targeted agents stem from wanting to understand basic programs that cells and tissues respond to for their proliferative signals and their survival programming. With regards to the immune therapeutics, the checkpoint inhibitors, for example, those largely came out of labs that were simply studying T-cell immunology, basic immunology that led to awareness that those programs could be leveraged to fight disease. Sustained funding has brought those ideas and approaches along to the clinic, where they're now FDA approved standard of care medicines. And so how do we advance those basic science discoveries is by funding from larger entities like the NIH, sustained funding in laboratories to help build research programs and advance basic science discoveries so that they can be translated and taken to the clinic. There's still a lot of biology we don't understand that requires new investments while we maintain investments in the translational pipeline from the discoveries of 10, 15, 20 years ago. We're all different. Our tumors are all different, even though they might be generically categorized or lumped into the same bucket. But with new age technologies along the lines of single cell sequencing technologies, single cell proteomics approaches, we understand the heterogeneity of tumors, where going forward, a patient will come in and their tumors will be personally diagnosed so that we can understand what the molecular targeted approaches that should be applied to their tumor because they have a vulnerability in that pathway, what their immune microenvironments look like within their tumors so that we can understand how to dampen the T-cell suppressive programs while simultaneously enhancing T-cell cytotoxicity, and combining those approaches with cytotoxic chemotherapy and radiation therapy in personalized approaches for every tumor. 30 years ago, if you were a woman diagnosed with breast cancer, that was your diagnosis. All breast cancers were considered the same. With modern approaches, molecular approaches, we appreciated that there were different kinds of breast cancer based upon molecular characteristics. A critical role for the AACR is around educating the public of why it's important that all groups are equally represented, but also to educate the legislatures about funding research that allows us to understand the features of risk that impact the disparities that we see in the cancer continuum. When I look into the future, I think personalized approaches will be standard of care as we leverage the power of single cell sequencing of malignant cells, but also of immune cells. And we put that together with biology, computational science, and perhaps artificial intelligence capabilities, we will be able to understand what the sensor is telling us about disease processes so that we can identify a process very early, eradicate it, treat it, so that it doesn't become a life-threatening issue. I see that being the biggest advance in the future, because that's the only way we're going to have a world without cancer.